Have you tried using this on your face?
Not yet.
Okay, good. Did you ever feel the urge to?
Yes.
Why?
Because I like destroying my face. Hi, this is Omar from Lab Muffin Beauty Science. I'm not a PhD in chemistry. I am not a skincare nerd, and apparently some of you might be horrified by my old skincare routine.
I'm sure many of you might have someone in your life, like a partner, your mum, your dad, your sister, your brother, who just has the worst skincare routine. And I mean, a lot of people are genetically blessed and generally they're fine with a frankly trash hot skincare routine. But sometimes there is just some things that just don't quite sit well with your spirit. They kind of mess up your chakras, your aura gets a bit tainted. So today I thought I'd talk about some products that might help ease them into good skincare habits that don't destroy your faith in all that is good and holy. This video is sponsored by Necessaire, and the reason I came up with this idea is because this is actually the one product that's in both our showers, and it's sort of like the product that got him out of this awful routine. I've eased him into a bunch of other products as well. There's another Necessaire product in there, but first, let's talk about what you used to do.
So 6 months ago, my skincare routine was quite literally just this and Tresemme shampoo. I used to use the shampoo not just on my hair, but all over my body when I ran out of the soap, and used to use the soap on my armpits, my back, my face, just hot swapping really, whatever I had available.
Hot swapping.
Hot swapping.
So Omar is a bit of a hard sell when it comes to skincare because he doesn't really have many major skin problems. And when he does get a pimple, he actually enjoys digging it out.
Yep.
So I found what works for Omar is a good gimmick.
Yep.
Utility packaging.
Yep.
And minimal skin feel afterwards.
Absolutely.
So obviously the first thing we had to fix was the soap and shampoo on your face.
What was wrong with that?
So let's start with the soap. The reason I went for the Necessaire body wash is because it is pretty much formulated like a face product. So this has the utility packaging, which Omar loves. It has a screw top. The top doesn't come off, and so you don't drop it. It's very easy to use for a bottle product, especially in the shower.
This twisty top should be included in all products. Love this.
This has a pretty nice scent. It's unisex, it's light, it leaves your skin pretty moisturized, unlike the bar soap. If you want to stock up on more of these magical twist tops, you can use the code LabMuffin10 for 10% off Necessaire. Okay, so bar soap, for those of you who don't know, is made of really long surfactants. So surfactants are the molecules that clean your skin. They have an end that lacks water and an end that lacks oil. So if you have the two of them in the one package, the oily end latches onto the oil in your skin, and then the watery end helps the oil dissolve into water. The problem with soap is that its surfactants are really long and narrow, and that means they get into your skin a lot more easily and they irritate. And they also have a charged head, which also adds to the irritation. So out of all of the surfactants that are commonly in skincare products, bar soaps have the worst in terms of irritation and dryness. Another reason bar soap is bad is because it tends to have a really high pH. Now on your body, that tends to be okay because your body has thicker skin. Some parts of your body also has a higher pH. So armpits, for example, and groin actually have higher pH, which means that soap isn't quite as bad. But on your face, this is one of those things that can lead to more acne. Your face likes to be at a low pH. At a higher pH, acne bacteria actually grow better. You're thinking about squeezing pimples now, aren't you?
Yep.
So that's why we don't like bar soap on our faces. Now, shampoo depends on the shampoo. Sometimes they're actually okay for your face. Shampoos typically have a higher concentration of surfactants because your hair has a higher surface area than your face. The more concentrated it is, the more cleaning power it has, and so shampoos are kind of like really concentrated cleansers.
So can I talk about why I started using shampoo?
Go on.
So I grew up thinking that I should be shampooing my hair every time I had a shower. And around the age of 13, I started needing more than one shower per day because I have a shower in the morning and a shower in the afternoon after playing sports. So I'd be showering twice a day. Occasionally I'd run out of soap, I'd run out of body wash, and, you know, I ended up using shampoo on the rest of my body, and at one point I put it on my face and it felt amazing.
What do you mean by amazing?
Dry.
So there's another problem we have. Omar likes that dry tight feeling, and a lot of people do, because they don't realize what it means is that your skin is getting warped.
Feels clean.
Skin's getting warped.
Okay.
So the dry tight feeling is actually surfactants going in and messing up the shape of the proteins in your skin.
Right.
When they change shape, that's what gives the tight feeling. And as you can imagine, proteins changing shape on your skin is not a good thing for your skin.
Right.
So this has surfactants that are commonly found in face products as well, which is why I'm comfortable giving this to Omar, because he can use it on his face and it's not that bad. In fact, it's actually fine. So on top of having nice gentle surfactants, this also has glycerin, which is hydrating. It also has niacinamide, so we're sneaking some actives into his routine as well. And so hopefully this leaves your skin feeling hydrated and not tight. Even though you like the tight feeling, but you'll get used to not having the tight feeling, I promise. Okay, so onto Omar's pimples. This is the main pimple treatment you were using before.
Yes, this is good.
Show me what you did to your pimples. Show the class what you did to your pimples before.
I feel like I'm about to get made fun of here.
All right, so here is a mole. Show us how you would squeeze
So what I would do is I'd take these tweezers and I just put them on the other side, each side of the pimple, and then push and then slightly squeeze, and it pops right out.
Slightly squeeze.
Slightly squeeze for me.
You were putting your whole back into it. I've seen you.
A little bit of blood doesn't really affect much.
So obviously we needed to make sure Omar didn't get pimples. And that's why we introduced the necessaire scrub and an exfoliating towel.
So this I love. I've got oily skin and I get pimples on my back all the time, and it's hard to reach. And this made a massive difference. Feels nice. I feel soft afterwards. I use it weekly. I've got a weekly routine.
You do.
My one complaint is, where's the twisty top? Come on. Where's the twisty top? This is like a screw top. Twisty top would be nice.
So I think the reason they don't have the twisty top is because this scrub, this actually contains particles. This has bamboo charcoal and pumice. And so the little bits might actually get stuck in the twisty top. I assume that's why. So originally I tried to make him use a leave-on chemical exfoliant, especially on his back.
No.
I tried to get him to use the Poreless Choice BHA, which is one of my favorites for my face. He doesn't like it. Why not?
Nah. Feels like, imagine putting vinegar or soy sauce on your skin. It just turns sticky. And who'd want that?
Imagine people who like clear skin.
It just feels off and weird.
So yeah, skincare favorite for us apparently just doesn't work with some people. I also gave him the spray version, and again, like, even though that was more convenient, it was still sticky.
Nah. Yeah.
I also tried this, which you were actually okay with.
But you have to do it.
So the Dr. Dennis Gross Peels, the nice thing about these, they are really expensive though. The nice thing about them is you can sort of get a whole bunch of uses out of one. So one of these is enough to do both our faces and both our backs. It's also a lot less sticky than the Paula's Choice version. I think the Stridex pads are also quite non-sticky as well, so that might also be an option. But again, it's a little bit harder to get to your back, whereas if you have a scrub combined with an exfoliating towel, then your person can do their back themselves. So another nice option, I think, for people who tend to use their body products on their face is the Dove Cream Beauty Bar. So this looks like a soap, but it's not actually a soap. They use surfactants that aren't soap surfactants, and it has a lower pH. So a lot of soaps, those surfactants only work at higher pH. So this has the gentler surfactants and the lower pH. So this makes it fine for your face. One of the issues some people say is that it breaks them out because of the creamy ingredients. But if it doesn't break you out, then this is actually one of the few bar soap looking products you can use on your face without worrying. So this is another product I gave to Omar. It's the Fenty Cleanser. And this is actually the only cleanser he uses because, what do you like most about it?
The twisty top. So this is my actual bottle that I'm using in the shower. So it's still a bit wet. So what I like about this product is that this is a goods twisty top. Made a massive difference in my skin. Makes my face feel amazing, especially compared to soap. Yes. Less breakouts, and compared to shampoo, this is way better.
Why is it better compared to shampoo?
Because it's less aggressive.
Little bubbles?
Little bubbles. Oh, bubbles.
Do you like the bubbles?
I like the bubbles. I also like the foaminess of this. It does foam up very nicely on my skin. Makes me feel like I'm cleaning my skin.
Now, on to sun protection. Now, one of the reasons I didn't give Omar a chemical exfoliant, even though that is often recommended for beginners, is because he doesn't wear daily sunscreen. And one of the things with telling people to use chemical exfoliants without daily sunscreen is that it often ends badly. It's so much harder to start someone on a sunscreen than it is to start someone on a chemical exfoliant. Now, on to your sun protection. This was your sunscreen. Tell me when you used it.
Right, so I used this when the UV rating was higher than 10 and I was going out to the walk for a long walk, or I was going to the beach and gonna go swimming. So I typically only use this on my face if I was going on a walk, and if I was at the beach and taking off my shirt and going into the water, then I'd use this all over my body.
So what was stopping you from using this more regularly? Because you go on walks a lot.
Yeah, it's mainly because I'm mainly trying to prevent myself from being sunburned on my face. So that was the main reason. Besides that, it's really sticky. Not very nice texture on my skin or on my hands. I hate it on my hands. That's it.
So being a sunscreen hoarder, I gave Omar a whole bunch of sunscreens that he could try out. Tell me what you thought of each of these.
This I didn't like. I don't like mousse on my skin. I don't like that feeling of putting like whipped cream on a surface and trying to spread it around. It's so awkward. I don't like this. And the cap. No. Utility is a big thing for me. Don't like it.
Yeah, so I actually thought Omar would like this because it's long-lasting, it sinks into your skin, and after it's sunken on, you can actually wash your skin with a bit of water and it's still fine. But apparently the film that's left on your skin afterwards still was too much. It does leave a little bit of a film because that's how it stays for so long.
Nah, hate it. As clear, smells like something is on fire when it shouldn't be. It also leaves a residue on my skin. Don't like that. And what's with the flip cup? You know, if I put this in my backpack, it's going to explode everywhere. Nah, don't like it.
So as much as we like to think everyone is fine with fragrance-free, a lot of people are not. And yeah, these are all things that I never even thought of considering when it came to recommending you a sunscreen. So interesting data collection.
By Ore. Nah, I like this one. This is the second from the top for me. It's really nice and light on my skin. Gives me SPF 50, which is really good.
50 plus.
Has a twist top, which is okay. Pretty good. Won't be worried about it exploding my backpack. And smells nice. So this I would use, but it's not my favorite. This, however, is my favorite, and this is La Roche-Posay. This one, it meets all the marks of my favorite sunscreen because it's nice and thin, light, doesn't leave a residue, and it smells nice. Actually does its job with protecting my skin. And the utility, okay, so it's not the twisty thing that, you know, Necessaire has, but nice screw top here. I'm not afraid of it exploding my backpack. This is the goods.
So how do you feel with your new routine?
I have a weekly routine.
Do you feel like a changed man?
I feel like I actually care about my skin. And this is weird. So my skin has gotten better. I have a weekly routine now and my skin's gotten better.
How's it gotten better?
Less pimples.
Mm.
And, you know, less dryness, less everything. It's just normal skin.
Mm.
Which is basically what I want. I don't really care about pigmentation. Don't really care about, you know, scabs or anything else like that. I don't really care. But it's gotten better. It's less annoying. That's me.
So I feel like that is a win. High five.
High five. Yeah.
This is Omar's routine before. And this is Omar's routine after.
Bior by Ore La Roche-Posay. La Roche-Posay.
Oh my gosh.
I don't really like mousse. What's this called again?
tweezers.